roundabout, traffic circle, or that thing in the middle of the road, whatever you want to call them, it certainly has people talking.
I like the roundabout.
I don't think they even serve any good purpose.
For people who dislike them, the bad news is the Michigan Department of Transportation says more are on the way.
We only do have approximately 7 in our regional area. There are 43 roundabouts on MDOT roads statewide, many more on local highways. In addition to those 43, we have several more planned.
Eric Tamlin is the Safety and Traffic Operations Engineer for MDOT Bay Region. He says they're looking at more roundabout locations for intersections that have both a high concentration of traffic and crashes.
We basically eliminate the head-on and left turn or angle T-bone type crashes by the installation of these roundabouts, so we're really improving safety.
If roundabouts improve safety, then why are they such a hot topic? TV5 visited with local businesses closest to two of the busiest roundabouts in mid-Michigan. Matthew Arnold works at Pioneer Quick Lube in Midland. He has a direct view of the US 10 business route roundabout.
I would say that doesn't serve any purpose. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it's not that good because it's just creating more problems.
Arnold has lived in Midland for 15 years. He remembers life before the roundabout and says he sees way more crashes now than he did before.
There was actually that one that was right up here by the pole, and that was a really loud one. That was the most recent.
But the crash data TV5 obtained from MDOT tells a different story.
We're at the US 10 Business Route roundabout here in Midland that was built back in 2014. Here's the annual crash and injury crash data from 2009 to the year that the roundabout was built. Now over here is the decrease in both of those categories 2 years after the roundabout was complete.
After checking out the roundabout in Midland, we headed down to Flint, where Joy Riopel has worked at the Marathon gas station on Bristol Road for 17 years. She says the roundabout right outside General Motors has made a huge difference.
I've not had any problems. I've not heard of any accidents recently since it's been there.
And she's right. We've learned since completion in 2016, the Bristol Road roundabout is down to an average of 11 crashes per year. MDOT says there were nearly 28 crashes every year in the 5-year period before construction.
So obviously they work. You know, roundabouts work.
Riopel's and Arnold's opinions may be miles apart, just like their roundabouts, but what they do agree on is that more public education could help with the apprehension towards change.
They are typically something where we get asked quite a bit of questions on, you know, I'm not familiar with this type of intersection, how will it operate, how do I drive this roundabout, and so we want to make sure that we also provide that time during the development of the project prior to when it's constructed to provide that information.
In this special report, I'm Cody Kaczynski for WNEM TV5.
Well, the two roundabouts coming to Mid-Michigan are on the interchange ramps in Mount Pleasant.
And you can learn more about roundabouts by going to the Hot Link section of the TV5 homepage.